Hey there, Angel of Galaxy, back with more channeled messages. I do hope you're all doing well. Thank you, thank you, thank you to each and every one of my subscribers. Honestly, it really does make my heart fill up with joy. Just want to say, if you'd like to support this budding little channel, I would appreciate that. The way to do so is subscribing, which is free, guys, liking, those are the two main ones, obviously viewing as well, but also commenting, sharing. And don't forget to hit the notification button so you know when I've got new content out. Thank you, thank you. Anyway, shall we get started? Okay. Remember, spirit works for us in mystical and mysterious ways. These messages may not go directly to the intended person. They may be talking about someone you know. It could be their loved lost one or a situation around you or them. Just remember, you just may be this heavenly post person, you know. It's really important. And of course, if I say male or female, remember we have both aspects of the divine feminine and masculine. So please take it as it resonates. Also, there is a rule of piggybacking. So the message may not seem like it's yours because it's got different names on it. Don't worry about that. There could be a message within a message. So, you know, spirit will work with one message and come through. So it could be just a name, it could be a date, it could just really mean something, you know, on a gut level. But yeah, okay, let's go. So Spirit wanted me to talk about what I heard this morning, which was loud and clear. Matilda. So if anyone knows the Matilda. Okay. Do you know, it's just such a lovely sunny day, you know. So I decided this morning to go for a little bit further out, you know, wander afar, so to speak. A change from my usual stroll. You know, as I was walking, I was kind of deep in thought. Just so grateful for the sun rays. That's when I noticed my next sign. I just gazed up, don't know why I gazed up, and the street sign said Matilda Street. So I thought, oh, okay, this is some of my signs and synchronicities. Now I know that there's a musical based on the Roald Dahl novel. Wasn't she called Matilda Wormwood? I always remember that, it's strange, isn't it, Wormwood? And she was a precocious 5-year-old girl. And she had the gift of telekinesis. She'd love reading. And she would overcome obstacles caused by her family and school and helps her teacher to reclaim her life. So, where's all this going? Well, I'm getting... Okay. Alright, so somebody might have been seeing objects moving around, because she's saying that this lady on the other side has the ability to do this. She can move objects at a distance by mental power or other non-physical means. So I feel for whoever I'm channeling for, you must have seen objects, you know. I've moved slightly, but then you're like rubbing your eyes and then sometimes dropping to the floor. In fact, you might find yourself a bit of a klutz thinking, why did I do that? And funnily enough, me myself, I put my mobile phone on the side of the bath the other day. Thank God there was no water in it. And suddenly, as I was watching it, it just flew off. So somebody was trying to get my attention. But I'm told that, going back to you, that it is a regular occurrence in your household. Yeah. And then my third sign, you know, I like them in threes, signs and synchronicities for the day, was a lady calling her Maltese dog. And of course, you guess it, Matilda, come here. Spirit, it do make me laugh. Yeah. Okay, so now I've got this reference to a book in particular. And a cup moving all by itself. It's fallen. No, I don't know. This is very strange. She's touching her nose. So this may be relevant. I don't know whether, you know, when you just tap the side of your nose. Maybe she's just saying, you know what's going on. Or you do now. So I'm told you and her had a true bond of friendship, equal status. You know when you just mirror your friend, you know? It just simply felt right when you were together. She said identical body postures of relaxation or alertness. Yeah, because that reinforces your special friendship, doesn't it? Yeah, take a moment if you're with a friend or somebody you really care about and look, if they cross their arms, you end up crossing your arms. It's so funny. Once you're aware of that, it can be quite annoying and then you try to, you know, reposition yourself, but it is, it's so true. Yeah, I don't know, something about shared identical attitudes as well to subjects, you know, when you were discussing things and posture. I think it's called postural, if I remember rightly, echo. She's saying she sure does miss her. She wants you to know that she's around you often and she's very much up to date on all things. Of course. She wants you to know that you are not staying where you are for long, as it's not serving you. You know, maybe it's a bit too noisy, but I'm also feeling there's not enough nature directly around you. And also I'm feeling like this soul wants to link arms with me. So this may be something you would do, you know, as you walk together. I'm told to mention purple dress and silver shoes. Okay. Oh, I'm not sure about this. Lily white. So maybe one of you may have had very pale skin, or both of you. But it can also mean that she thinks you're very pure too. You'd have to work that one out, I'm afraid. I don't know why, but there's a need to be silent. Maybe it's so that you can feel her, hear her. Yeah, maybe. Now I've got Lucy, Tully, Val, Larry and Wills in this. Now remember, these could be on the other side of the veil. They could be here in your environment, in your family. Could be the names of the people who are watching this as well. But anyway, I've also got R and C initials, F and P, S and L, P and Y, D and N. It's very important. January seems very, and fall time, funnily enough, autumn time. Sunday is very relevant with this message. I have 78, 49, 6, 5 and 29 could be crossing over dates, door numbers, a special number, a birthday date, the list could go on. Take what resonates and leave the rest for somebody else to enjoy. Okay, let's talk a little bit about people who've crossed over, you know. Can they speak to you in your dreams? Well, there's two different things, you know. There's dreams and then there's visits. Both of them happen, of course, when we're sleeping. But a dream is usually convoluted and often has a psychological root. Generally, a dream needs to be interpreted before we can get any message from it. But a visit is straightforward, and it's usually very short and sweet. You know, we'd see our loved ones and we can hear them. We hear their actual voice. But the communication is telepathic. You know, you won't see their lips moving as they are communicating with their minds. Our subconscious mind will remember the visit and the message will be clear. Unlike a dream, it will not take any interpretation. Oh my gosh, I can't speak now. Interpretation. Sorry, that's what happens when spirit keep moving my thoughts out of my head to bring their thoughts in. And sometimes I'm better at it, but other times I just go a bit, ooh. Anyway. Okay, where are we? Okay, what's next, guys? Alright, so now I'm seeing a car. It feels like somebody... Okay. It's returning home from an army base. Somebody who's worked quite far away. They had to fly to come back to you, you know? And it's been a while, I'm told, as well. Oh, well, your loved one on the other side is saying this visit will bring you so much joy to you and the children. Oh, she says it's not been very easy. You have been struggling. But she wants you to keep going. Yeah, and look forward. So I've got Philip, Janice, Gordon, Neil, and Anton. But the initials I have with it, oh sorry, Vicky. I've got, yeah, sorry, Denise. I've got the initials F and G, S and P, E and N, D and J. Okay, with that one, thank you. Just a short popping. Okay, so let's go to my song, shall we? So for anybody who knows, the song Hey Jude. Now feel free to change the Jude to a name, your name. Okay, let's go. So for all of you who don't know, I use signs and synchronicities, but I also get a song in my head. It'll be playing away and then I will work on using the lyrics because this is what a loved one would like, okay? Now the song may mean something to you, you know? It might just be a line in the song, a chorus. So take it as it resonates. Or they just want you to go and listen to the song because there could be something there. So we have, Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart. Then she can start to make you feel better. So what this loved one's saying is it's time to move forward. And she's giving you her blessings. As this is a match made in heaven. Okay, so it's a mother, I feel. She's telling you that love is much needed right now. Oh, so don't procrastinate. Hey Jude, don't be afraid. You were made to go out and get her. The minute you let her under your skin, then you begin to make the pain so much better. Yeah, see, a new relationship will bring another type of love and closeness, which is really missing in your life, I'm told. And anytime you feel the pain, Hey Jude, refrain. Don't carry the world upon your shoulders. It was time to leave this life. And I want you to be happy and settled with someone decent. Someone kind and caring. For well, you know that it's a fool who plays it cool by making this world a little colder. Remember, I'm working with the lyrics. Hey Jude, don't let me down. After all this time, you have found her, so do not lose her. Now go and get her. Let the grief out and let the love in. Remember to let her into your heart. Then you can start to make it better for the both of you. And of course, I. Hey Jude, begin. You're waiting for someone to approve. So yes, so here it is. But it is really up to you. Hey Jude, I hope this message will spur you on to find that inner most joy through sharing love with another. I know the loss of me has made you paranoid about getting really close to someone else and then having to face a painful separation. But she wants you to know this one will be worth taking a chance on. Mum is the word I'm hearing. Oh. Hey, you know you can make it, Jude. Jude, you're gonna get a break. You're gonna break it, sorry. Love always, and she misses you terribly. I'm hearing Luke, Christian, Bri, Kirk, Anthony, Dean, Earl, Letitia, and Caroline. Now, if your name's not there, doesn't mean the message is not for you, remember? Message within a message. Okay, thank you very much for that. Okay, where are we going next? Oh, my healing words for the angels. Working in conjunction with heavenly guides, your changes will come about in a momentum way. Angel number for today, which is 619. Stay positive about your career and finances and put your entire focus on serving a spiritual purpose through your work. I just want to say a little bit about memories as well. Love is where the heart is. The memories that you and your loved ones created in this life live on in your heart for all time. Memories stay with you forever. They can never go away. They're always there for you to enjoy. So remember and relive those wonderful, happy and unique moments you shared. Okay, and I've got a next message coming in. I'm feeling a real tightening of my chest, okay? Oh, gosh. You can take that away, please. Okay. Right, so, this loved one's showing me this because somebody who's this message is for, this normally happens to you when you get to work, or even when you're thinking about work. Maybe you haven't even put that together yet. There's a real tension and tightness with this. It's very unpleasant. So I'm seeing one or two males with this message who make you feel so uncomfortable. And if I've been showing like a false smile, you know? Maybe you put on this false smile, but it doesn't reflect your inner mood. Now, I'm told you have a desk near a window, and it's not a huge space. And you prefer to sit at your desk for lunch when they'd all gone out. Look, they're telling you, you mustn't, you know? Go for a walk to clear your mind. You know, this will cleanse your aura as well. It would also help you to remain sharp. I've got September very strongly in August, but also May, so it could be birthdays, anniversaries, passing. Just a time of the year that's could be nice, or, you know, you take it as it resonates. Number 7 seems relevant, 55, 32. 12, 5 and the number 8. I have the name Kelly, the last name Wilson, the last name Young, Hall, Bremer with 2 M's, Max, Carmen, Strutt, Catherine, Helen, Tracy and Maxine with that one, thank you. Okay, let's see, have we got another one? Yeah, one more, I think, maybe. Okay. So I'm hearing, we all view aging exciting when young. You know, that eager anticipation of growing up, and as depressing when old. The physical decline. Oh, okay. All right. So this loved one's eager to tell you to stop wanting to be an age. You are not. Every age has something special to offer. So accept it for what it is. You will one day become older and wiser and more experienced. But until then, enjoy, as then you'll most likely crave eternal youth and struggle to regain it. Isn't that the truth? Oh, my. This person say, live in the present and use it to the full. Eat life up greedily. Never procrastinate. And never think it's too late. There's a dark corner in one of the rooms in your home. Feeling that strongly. All right, so maybe it would be a good idea. I don't want to frighten you or anything, but maybe just a good idea to clear it up and try to keep it free of clothes and items, okay? All right. So you may have a sister or something, because I'm seeing a little mischievous girl around you. That's on the earth plane, by the way. And if that doesn't apply to you, then that could be a spirit child, okay? You've got a lot of spirit support, I'm feeling that, yeah. Many passed on ancestors around you, helping you out. Also, I'm hearing the magic of transformation is cast over you. Interesting. So delve deep and decide what changes you want to make in your life. Okay. So I'm told that this loved one, who is bringing this message, is stern but a very loving man. Average height. He would have been bald as he got older. Or may have had a few... You know, like the comb over, yeah. It's just a little pot belly. I don't know whether that's a porcupine, he'll lie. He may have liked to watch sports because I can hear, you know, things speeding around a track, you know, so cars. Also, could have been football or something like that, but some type of sport. Could be kind of, yeah, I'm feeling like a grandfather or a dad link with this, okay? Male lineage. So no matter what you see or feel, he wants to remind you to always keep your sense of humour about it. It's always better to look for humour in things than the divine spirit can lend you a guiding hand with that. Oh, interesting, thank you. Okay, so the names I've got, Georgina, D, Violet, Carl, Pat. Okay, George, Lewis, Mina, Joe, Elsie, Pamela, R and T comes to mind, E and K, J and B and P and W initials. June is very strong in July. Remember, these could be birthdays, passing dates, yeah, anniversaries. I've got the number 67, number 89, 59, 4, 7 and 9. Also Wednesday as well. Okay, thank you for that. Remember, just take what resonates and leave the rest for somebody else. Okay. Let's have a look at what we've got card-wise today. My first card out. Okay. Well, obviously something's been burnt down to the ground. Reminds me of the war days for some reason, you know. Maybe 1940s or... I feel this person would have been very young at that point of, yeah... Obviously this is a general read, but that's what I'm feeling with this. Arthur comes to mind. Don't know why I'm hearing Aaron. Oh, Okay, so I'm being told that you've got quite angry, you know? Maybe you've been pointing your finger at someone. This is a grandfather figure, or even a father figure, but yeah, there's a lot of age with this person on the other side. They didn't pass young, okay? So when you're thinking about a war, you know, if you're giving that out, so this is what they want to say to you here on the earth plane, if you're giving that out, you're going to get this war back, okay? You're going to get these words back, because negative energy will bring back negative energy. Anger will bring back energy. Anger will bring back, sorry, I should have slept well last night. Anger. So yeah, it's like a boiling pot, I'm feeling, you know, of emotions, wrath, you know, rah of words. So this was extremely, it's not a very nice energy. I think he might have got to fisticuffs a bit, you know, the fists. What this loved one's saying is really, really, you know, it's time for healing. Yeah. So try and make a plan for the both of you, you know. Because you're both going to have to want this really badly, you know. The same initiative and determination. And you need to start figuring it out. Go with your intuition as well, because intuition is really, really important, isn't it?
Let's see.
Now we've got the Three of Wands. Yeah, look, foresight for a start with the Three of Wands. Look, as you're going into this and wanting to whoever's going to step forward to do this, just imagine, you know, that change, it's always going to happen, okay? Nothing's going to stay stagnant with this. And the Three of Wands talks about change. So this could happen within 3 days or 3 weeks, okay? That you start to try and make amends with whatever's gone on. As I say, it could be different for different people. But what I see with this lady as well is, you know, maybe she is looking for a way to move, you know. And when we talk about Mars, Mars can come in pretty strong, and Aries can be very strong as well. I know with the Aries star sign, for instance, you know, the headstrong leaders, you know, they can be fiery and masculine, you know, even if they're feminine, forceful and quite ambitious. So yeah, and this lady is looking at, she doesn't look like she's ready to go to war here. It's like, how can I make amends, you know, with this? You know, when we think of Wands, we're thinking about that confidence, and that's what you need now, and that courage, you know, to take this action. You know, it doesn't mean you're weak if you're the one who takes the first step forward. It really means that you're very strong. And we have a number three here as well. So when I'm thinking about that, you know, what does that mean, three? Healers and teachers as well, you know. So maybe this is a lot of healing coming in with the number three. I don't think this is a very young person. I think you're quite mature as well. So I think, try to work this out. There was a wonderful emotional connection with the both of you. Maybe you were part of some type of community as well. But yeah, you have the knowledge to go forth and build up a new state of this friendship that used to be, or whatever way you're looking at it. Let me just check my camera. Yes, we're okay. Sorry. I have quite a lot going on outside for some reason, but okay. So with the Three of Pentacles.